The main problem at Shelsley is to work your way to the start line. The hill itself is almost deserted. Sydney Allard proves it's not really necessary to lift your foot. A Lotus takes the right line into the S's, followed by a Cooper Bobtail, quite new to the hill at this time. The Hull brothers warm up the ERA, while Chris Summers tells the organisers what to do with their regulations. And an ERA is way off the hill. Into the S's and out the other side neatly. Basil Davenport, the GN Spider, coming to the line. Basil and his Spider have been competing at Shelsley for over 30 years and at one time held the outright record. Shelsley is 1,000 yards long with an S-bend 3/4 of the way up. Speed through the S's can be a deciding factor to your time. Twin rear wheels are helping the ERA through the S's. Back in the paddock, the championship class prepare for their final run. Being a driver's wife certainly keeps you fit. David Good takes very little time in his immaculate Cooper Twin. And it's flat out to the S's. Reg Phillips moves down to the line. And David Good arrives at the S's in fine form. Followed by Reg Phillips in the transverse engine Cooper. Bosher Jones is neat and fast as usual. You don't have to be neat, but things can go a little bit out of hand if you enter the S's a bit too quickly. And some get completely carried away. That was Rupert Instone in the gin. Nobody's harmed, and the car is ready for another run. Hot weather was beginning to melt the tar on the entrance to the S's, as the hill had been resurfaced for this year's season. ERAs can have twin rear wheels, then why not a Cooper? Nervous? Not me. Tony Marsh, holder of the Hill record, comes to the line. Tony is quickest of the lot at this stage of the meeting. Henderson in the supercharged Cooper Twin, driven to the limit by one of our best hill climbers. Patsy Burke, on her way to make fastest time of the day by a lady driver. Had to use the ejector seat, old boy. One careful driver, used only weekends.